Well, it's always, always the most dramatic of events, the men's 100 metres. The eyes of the world on Usain Bolt to see if he can produce just another dramatic chapter in the most spectacular sprinting career. And there's the full lineup, the official lineup. And you see Usain Bolt starting in lane five. And talked about the draw of Walter Dix, the American, good draw alongside him with Kim Collins, who's bang in form in lane three, and Yohan Blake. Now, we've seen him running in terrific shape this season, and he looked very good. He was the quickest semi-final qualifier. But this is all about Usain Bolt, surely, Ewan Thomas.
It has to be. I mean, I am just smiling with anticipation. He was electric in the heats and the semi-final, and he was trying probably for, what, 45, 50 metres? If he runs to the line, like the guy set up in the studio, he's going to run really quick. I don't know if the wind conditions are perfect. I don't think we'll see a world record, but we are seeing Usain Bolt back to his best. He is absolutely loving out there. He's doing his showmanship bit. He's waving to the crowd. You know he's ready.
25 years old, and he looks as though he's found some fabulous form as he's come here to these championships. A shout from Usain Bolt as he tries to just psych himself up for one last time and maybe get a little bit of a psychological advantage over his principal opponents. There's Christophe Lemaitre in lane eight, the Frenchman. Walter Dix right alongside Usain Bolt. Such a tall man, almost has to uncoil himself from the start position, but you heard Michael Johnson saying he's getting that start absolutely right.
Set.
Oh, my word, is it a false start? I think Usain Bolt false started. No. I can't believe it. I think Usain Bolt, almost unthinkably, I was talking about the fact that he got his start absolutely right. Has he false started? The reaction of Bolt suggests that most emphatically is the case.
He knows it's him. He took his top straight off. He's looking to the heavens there. I can't believe it. For the neutral of us here, now this is an open race, because with him out of the picture, is it Bolt? Let's see. Yes, clearly he goes. We have seen so many false starts in this championships already, and it's only day two.
Well, I can hardly believe what I'm seeing. It'll take them a second or two to reset as now the card is being delivered to Usain Bolt. And we'll go up into the studio and get a bit of reaction from Michael Johnson and Tyson Gay. What do you make of that, fellas?
Unbelievable what we're seeing here. And it wasn't even close. I was just talking to Tyson and we were both agreeing. You know, you don't take your shirt off and just, yeah. I mean, don't take your shirt off, right?
Right. I mean, the crowd was still, you know, making a little bit of noise, camera flash and stuff like that. I think he could have protested.
You've got to protest it. I mean, even though it's blatant, absolutely, it's a false start, yes. But you've got to protest it just in case there's something, cameras flicking, something yes. That you can say, hey, that threw me off. They may not let it back in, but in all honesty, it's Usain Bolt. Maybe yeah. They would. Unbelievable what yes. We're seeing, because the race was his. He doesn't need to get
a great start.
Absolutely, he doesn't need to get a great start, but we've been talking about that start, and maybe that was the thing. Oh, I want to get an even better one. Unfortunately,
it's wide open. The race is wide open. Anybody can win.
Well, they now have to reset. Usain Bolt, so far as this particular race and this particular day is concerned, in competitive terms, is history. But that was headlines. Now we see who's going to be the winner. Good start from lane three from Kim Collins, who's out of the blocks really fast. Coming back at him is Blake for Jamaica. It could still be a Jamaican gold. Blake wins it, and silver. Well, it's going to be close on the line between Kim Collins and Walter Dix for the United States. No Usain Bolt, but it's still gold for the brilliant sprinting nation of Jamaica. Yohan Blake had to respond to another electric start from Kim Collins, but react he did. He came past, storming down the the straight, and he takes the gold medal in a season's best time of 9.92. Walter Dix on the dip just takes the silver, fractions, 1/100th of a second ahead of Kim Collins, who remarkably at the age of 35 takes a bronze medal, and it was into a strong headwind, 1.4 metres per second. Yohan Blake, he wasn't upset by the departure of Usain Bolt. Perhaps he could scarcely believe it, but he regained focus, regained composure, and he's taken gold.
And that's not easy to do. There was a lot of disruption down there. The biggest global superstar in the world has gone out. He kept his composure, as you said. He did his own thing, and he's come out with the season's best when it matters. Fantastic. And I've got to say, so pleased for Kim Collins. He started so well in every round, got himself a bronze medal.